जो है जैसा क्यों है वैसा, जो है होता क्यों है होता। हे जो है जैसा क्यों है वैसा, जो है होता क्यों है होता। चमत्कार नहीं सच बतलाए, सिद्ध करके हम दिखलाए। जो है जैसा क्यों है वैसा, जो है होता क्यों है होता। हे जो है जैसा क्यों है वैसा, जो है होता क्यों है होता।
Ago, green revolution was ushered in and fertilizers played a pivotal role in it. Chemical fertilizers like urea played a very important role in this revolution. These fertilizers helped in increasing the productivity and took agriculture to new heights.
Whether it is trees or other plants, humans, or any other forms of living beings, everyone needs food and nutrition to survive. Trees and other plants derive most of their nutritional needs from nature, utilizing air, water, and minerals from the soil and the sun's light and heat. But often, special nutritional supplements are needed for fulfilling the special needs of some plant varieties. Fertilizers are such chemicals that help plants fulfill their special needs. Urea is such a chemical supplement that is often needed to increase the fertility of the soil. It is a colorless, odorless, white, solid, granular chemical compound. In the world of carbon chemistry, urea is also known as carbamide. Being rich in nitrogen, it is an essential soil nutrient. It dissolves readily in water and is absorbed by the soil, making it easy for plants to absorb it and use it for their nutritional needs. That is why it is used widely in agriculture as a nitrogen-adding chemical compound. Urea is used the world over as a soil nutrient for agricultural farmlands. Urea is used also as a raw material in the production of plastics, urea formaldehyde resins, glues, hydrogen, etc. Urea-based feeds are also given to cattle to supplement their metabolic nitrogen needs.
Not only this, urea is also used to make a medicine called urea stebumin, which is very effective in the treatment of disease called Kala-Azar. In fact, urea is also used to make some other medicines also. Not only that, urea is also used in our vehicles as a pollution controller. Who could have discovered this multi-utility substance and how?
German chemist Friedrich Wöhler was the first scientist in the world to synthesize an organic compound from an inorganic compound. The discovery was largely accidental, and he was not attempting to do this, since he too, like other scientists of his age, believed that it is not possible to synthesize organic compounds from inorganic ones outside the body of an animal. Swedish chemist Jons Jakob Berzelius stating that he had artificially synthesized urea without the use of animal or human urine. Till then, the world of chemistry had been following the theory of Berzelius that organic chemical compounds such as urea could not be manufactured outside the animal body, because to do that needs what Berzelius called the vital force of living beings, including humans. And this is how he proved the earlier tenets wrong, and thus laid the foundation of organic chemistry. Following this discovery, urea became a key chemical in developing the chemical industry. This added a huge momentum to the chemical industry. Acharya Prafulla Chandra Ray gave new directions to the chemical industry in India by founding the Bengal Chemicals and Pharmaceuticals in 1892. The company still exists and produces vitamins, cosmetics, asthma drugs, and many other important chemicals. Hey, jo hai jaisa kyun hai, waisa jo hai hota kyun hai hota.
Red, yellow, green, blue. All these colors attract us a lot, don't they? But do you know, chemicals are behind all these colors. Take a look.
The myriad colorful objects adorning the shops in our marketplaces attract us easily. Whether these are bangles, clothes, or toys, we are surely drawn to them by the beautiful colors and desire to own them. However, the principal factor that draws us to these articles is the colors used in them. Many years ago, natural dyes were used as coloring agents for various things. These used to be made out of flowers and plant leaves and other parts of plants. But gradually, the demand for dyes and colors increased, and the supply of natural dyes could not match the demand. That is when the need for creating artificial dyes was felt. And soon, William Henry Perkin unleashed a major new wave within the then ongoing Industrial Revolution by synthesizing the first artificial dye in England. In 1856, Perkin was working on synthesizing quinine from coal tar when he mixed aniline and sodium dichromate. It suddenly produced a rich purple color. Made from aniline, it was commercially named Morvine, and Perkin got a patent for this in 1857 when he was just 18 years old. Later on, Perkin also produced two other major colors named Britannia Violet and Perkin's Green. By 1862, more than a dozen new artificial dyes had been created. Perkin's discovery of the first synthetic dyes became a major boost to the textile industry.
Different types of clothes were made available as the textile industry kept growing. Now there was a need for different dyes for different clothes. But
Why is it so?
Compared to natural dyes, synthetic dyes are much more stable and fast, which means they do not get discolored by washing in water, alkalis, and acids. These dyes are also able to withstand higher levels of heat. The atoms of dyes bind to each other due to additive bonds, covalent or valency bonds, hydrogen bonds, ionic bonds, and van der Waals force. Dyes can be classified into three categories: substantive dyes, VAT dyes, and mordant dyes. Substantive dyes are usually used to color cotton, paper, leather, wool, silk, and nylon. VAT dyes have been used since ancient times by humans, and in practical usage, it is insoluble. These are used primarily to color cotton fabric. Mordant dyes are a kind of dye that need a binder to be used as a fast coloring agent for cotton cloth. Mordants are primarily inorganic oxides or salts which are absorbed by the cloth. It is important to note that many mordants, particularly those in the heavy metal category, can be hazardous to health, and extreme care must be taken in using them. Almost 30% of all dyes used on wool are mordant dyes. Indigo, methyl orange, and aniline yellow are synthetic dyes. Acid-based dyes are mostly used to color wool, nylon, and silk. Alkaline dyes are used to color paper. Food colors are a special category of dyes, which are used primarily to add color to food items. These food colors are industrially produced, but use specific methods so as to avoid harmful effects because they directly impact human health.
Some time back, such tomatoes were available that would burst even if they were pressed slightly in our bags. But nowadays, such tomatoes are available in the market that would remain unaffected even if they were pressed in our bags or if they fall on the floor. What could be the reason behind this?
In today's world, biotechnology plays a very major role, be it in the field of medicine, food industry, or agriculture. It involves the science of studying the active principles and components, as well as the chemical properties of biotechnological entities. Biotechnology is being used to enhance the nutritional quality and pest resistance of many crops. Besides this, major experiments are being conducted to select certain genes of particular species and transferring the genes to other species to produce precisely the quality of crops that we desire. These are being termed as genetically modified crops or GM crops. Some years ago, scientists at the New Delhi-based Jawaharlal Nehru University implanted the genes of amaranth or amdana, a highly nutritious food grain, into potatoes and boosted the protein content of potato to a very high degree. Such kind of research producing highly nutritional food through biotechnology is very useful for poor and developing countries to combat the menace of malnutrition. scientists have also produced such a variety of cotton that has eliminated the need for the spraying of chemical pesticides on the cotton plants. What the scientists did was to introduce the gene of the otherwise highly poisonous soil bacteria called Bacillus thuringiensis into cotton plants, creating a variety called BT cotton that was able to resist the attack of a dangerous pest called cotton bollworm. Similarly, the scientists have already developed strains of corn that is pest resistant. New genetically modified soybean varieties have also been developed that can withstand severe pest infestation. Biotechnology has also been successful in producing what is termed as terminator seeds, which produce high volumes of the crop and are pest resistant. However, the problem with such terminator seeds is that they can be used only once to grow that particular crop. The seeds produced cannot be used to grow new plants. There has been strong opposition to genetically modified crop technology and the use of terminator seeds, especially due to the adverse impact such crops may have on the environment. But there is great hope that science will soon be able to get out of this impasse. Scientists are using biotechnology to hasten the creation of synthetic organic compounds. And it is entirely possible that someday in the future, scientists will be able to create artificial blood. If that happens, then the thousands of people injured in accidents or wars may not have to die for lack of blood. It might become possible to treat a part of the body that has become unusable due to disease and replace it with an artificial body part. And maybe someday scientists will create microorganisms that will eat away plastics and clean the environment. As of now, these seem like hopes for the future, but it is truly possible with the giant steps that science is taking to make these possible.